Beginning with late breaking news happening right now, first and fast off the ground to the WLKY news chopper hovering above Old Louisville near 3rd and St. Catherine, where police have arrested a suspect suspected of robbing a J-Town bank not too long ago. Let's bring in chopper pilot Bill DeReamer, who's over the scene as you can see now. Bill, what can you tell us about this?
Eric, good afternoon. Yes, we are in fact over Old Louisville, right in the area of Walnut Street Baptist, right off of St. Catherine and Old 3rd Street, where a suspect in a robbery was just recently taken into police custody. Now, what we understand is that about 11:18, the BB&T branch bank was robbed off of Bluegrass Parkway. Now, the suspect fled there and got onto I-64, and just by chance, there was a police officer that was on I-64 and picked up the description of the car on his radio, and that's where he attempted to pull this vehicle over. At that point, there was a high-speed chase that took him down I-64 westbound into downtown Louisville, and then I-65 southbound, where the suspect exited at St. Catherine Street and made his way down to 3rd Street, where he took a left right there where the Walnut Street Baptist Church is, what you're looking at right there. The suspect attempted to flee at that point, and he was taken into custody by police. We understand that this suspect was armed at the time, but right now he is in police custody.
All right, Bill, I know that's a very populated area of the city, especially this time of day, from residential traffic to business traffic. Are they blocking off streets down there? I can't tell.
Well, there is quite a bit of traffic right now in this area because 3rd Street at St. Catherine is blocked, which is a southbound road, an artery down towards the University of Louisville or south out of Louisville. So if this is part of your commute today, St. Catherine is backed up. 3rd Street is closed, so this whole general area is got quite a bit of congestion. And to add to that is right now this is the weekend for St. James Art Fair, so there could be a lot of vendors trying to make their way in to set up for this. So right now it's an area that I would definitely avoid, Eric.
A very good point there, Bill. Didn't think about that, the St. James Art Fair. At the very least, no one injured. Sounds like some fast police work here. We certainly appreciate the report, Bill. Thanks so very much.